Comfortable. And I'm back. This is your boy, Humbled Mumbles, with just the best reactions on YouTube. We're going to jump right into Eminem, Paradise, featuring Post Malone. Now, I do like Eminem. I don't like all his songs, but I do like Eminem. I've heard one Post Malone song. It was Goodbyes. It was okay. You know, it wasn't the best thing I've ever heard, I think. I mean, if I remember correctly. I thought the video was kind of cool. I didn't understand what the video had to do with the song. But maybe the video was a continuation of another video. So I don't know there. But this is cool because I've gotten requests to listen to more Post Malone. So let's check it out. From what I understand, he's a pretty chill dude. Doesn't even start any beef. So we'll listen to more of his music and maybe I'll find something I like. Okay? You know? And I'm never going to knock anybody for getting their money. You know, it is what it is. Kids love him. And I don't mean like he's made for kids. I'm just talking about, you know, my athletes and my students. That's all I meant by that. So let's get right into this. Eminem Paradise featuring Post Malone. Wrong monitor. It's just me or the music is way overwhelming to his voice, but I'm not hearing the auto-tune here. I'm hearing just him, and I like it so far. And I can kind of make out what he's saying. You know, the girl is acting out of line and he's gonna choose another girl, and I think that's what he said. Correct me if I'm wrong. Let's go. You know, this could be a song where you're just laying back, eyes closed, and you're just relaxing, right? You're just chilling. Maybe you're sitting on your porch, chilling with whatever you drink, and just relaxing. This has got a really relaxing flow to it. I have a feeling that might change once Eminem gets into it, but we'll see. Okay, this is something that I could jam to as well. I'm not lying. I could play it in the car on a real long drive and just let it just be nice, especially if it's a nighttime drive. And I'm just letting it be nice and calm, and you know, I love listening to my music at night when we drive. Anytime we drive, it doesn't even have to be at night. I just love listening to music. But usually that's the time the kids are asleep. The wife's kind of conked out, but she doesn't really sleep on the drives either. And that's when the music's really being played. Because during the daytime, you know, it's all about, you know, this kid's talking and this kid's talking and this one's crying. And, you know, we're just trying to keep everybody, you know, in their own seats and out of each other's comfort zone. And, you know, oh, he touched me. I'm not touching you. He's touching me. I'm not touching you. You guys know what I mean. But I love my kids. I be on my own. How this shit I write? I saw you thought all things would fall apart. Somebody messed with him, but he sounds like he's moving on, right? Because he said something about now he's in paradise. So when's Eminem going to come on this? Is this even Eminem's song? Is this really Post Malone Paradise featuring Eminem? Is that what this is? Because, I mean, it's a picture of Post Malone. So maybe the title is just way wrong. maybe they pop that title up there to fool everybody and to get views. And maybe this isn't a 2019 song. Maybe this song came out in 2017. I don't know. I've been living under a rock, guys. So I'm like Patrick from SpongeBob. You know, me and him, that was my neighbor. We shared a bunk bed. That'd be cool, though. So seeing the rest is finna take me on a ride. Running out of time. Now with your family's letters, I guess I better try to explain. A lot's happened in between them since I rise to this fame. I said your name, but always tried to hide the face. But this game is crazy. I wanted to play my love for you, but dang, I never knew it'd be like this. If I did, I wouldn't have done it. You ain't asked for none of this shit. Now- is this even supposed to go together? Because it don't sound like it does. I don't want to say the wrong thing and like destroy my career before it starts, but it just sounds like it's not mixed together very well. Let me know, please. Am I a fool for doing this? And if not, oh well, because you're getting this true, honest reaction. But right, I'm to be honest, I like Post Malone's part, but Eminem's part, I'm not liking it. It's just weird. It's just the sound of it, I mean. It's almost distracting, right? I can't even really listen to it because it's so distracting. You're being punished, things that should have been private with me and your mother is public. I can't stomach, they can take this fame back, I don't want it. I'll put out this last album that I'm done with it. 100% finished, fed up with it, I'm hanging it up, fuck it. All things would fall apart. And I know that from somewhere. But I'm old, I got that old-timers brain syndrome thing. You guys know what I'm talking about, right? Old-timers brain syndrome. It's like OTBS. This just has to be something somebody mixed up. And they didn't even do it very well. And if it's not, M, I'm sorry. Post Malone, I'm sorry. Don't hate me and kill my career, please. Don't make a rap diss about me. Well, actually, do it because then I might get some views. But then he might hurt my feelings and... Well, you know what? I don't know. Either way, come on. Guys, seriously, this can't be what they put together. There's no way. As talented as I've heard Post Malone is with his music and his beats, and we know the production value from Eminem, there's no way they came together, released this, and said, okay, this is cool. You ever recorded something and you're watching it and you're like, oh, and you fast forward to the end real quick because you just want to see something, but then you go back and you're shocked, or like Christmas Eve and you're not supposed to peek. Actually, it's like weeks before Christmas and you found the presents in the closet and you want to peek so bad, but you don't. And then you peek and you get disappointed. Or better yet, you're about to go see this bomb movie, you just can't wait, but you couldn't go open a day, you had to wait like a week. So you hit the reviews and you read that spoiler review and you're like, you know, it ain't gonna affect the movie for me. But then it does affect the movie for you. I think we just did it. I mean, 5 minutes and 13 seconds, seriously? And they're gonna put a purple screen on the